This should be interesting, you know. And Mira is from Spain, and he got like a Spanish invitation. He won the Spanish tournament, so that's pretty epic. So I want to see how this turns out.
So that's
out.
A VIP player, right?
Yep.
Okay.
That's a VIP player from Namco.
So Negato77, I forgot to mention, won the PC qualifier.
Okay, nice. And the thing I've got against Negato77 is that I've never beat him ever since we played an online game. So all I can say is he's good. He's really good. So I'm interested to see what techniques he's got. Okay. Interesting choice.
So yeah, Negato is only using Naruto and Sasuke, but that's a really powerful team anyway, you know. And once again, having one character doesn't make you weaker or at a disadvantage because it refills much faster.
I think it all
He's
matters
with
about
no
the
subs,
skill
though,
level.
That can be problematic. He has to be very careful right now.
If you're going to pick one support, you better know you got skills to master those, then you're good. All right. He's got Pain and Hinata, very good supports on Mira's side.
I have to say, those Naruto costumes were confusing me a little. I am...
They're very distinguished, but very... an odd choice. I would never pick the one that Negato is wearing, but you know, of course.
Yeah, Naruto has a weird sense of fashion style.
I call it the old of a twist.
Alright, the guard is about to break. Negato is taking a damage combo right now. Alright.
Interesting.
Oh, he failed his garlic build.
I get a feeling that Negato is kind of just having fun. Because he can play very intense.
I think he's trying to gauge the opponent right now more than trying to get in. Like, you might seem like he's failing a lot of his actions, but as you can see, it's working because his health is definitely higher. Mm. Alright, he switched to Sasuke. It's Rin against Sasuke, so that's the one that does a really good grab. Got his subs back.
Match
so did Mirai. There's only two subs left for Negato, though. So what makes Negato so strong is that he has a really good defense. He knows how to run away. He knows how to use the counter. Mm. He knows how to defend himself whenever he's losing his subs.
I haven't played against him in a long time.
Yeah. But yeah, as you can see, Negato is trying to gain so much time, he's going to get his subs back.
The pace of the matches.
Yeah, they're both trying to wait for one another.
Yeah.
Eventually, it's the one losing, right? The player losing. If he doesn't want to lose to the timeout, he has to get in.
Yeah. Gotta go on the offense. You gotta go on the offense.
Sadly, getting in against Negato is not easy.
It's not easy.
Especially when he's waiting for you to do it. Great counter.
To think how much more punishable counters were in the previous game.
Yeah, in the previous games, a counter would stun the opponent.
Yep.
You know, stun lock him for a full 5 seconds, which was a bit ridiculous, let's be honest.
So it's actually like 11 seconds and you were completely defenseless.
Yeah. Alright. So Negato takes the first round. Now back to playing Sasuke.
I wonder if Negato is going to want to get a two-round win. It's not really priority.
Once again, if Mirai gets a bit too confident, Negato is going to finish him. Like right now, look at it. Mm. So only one sub for Negato, but once again, he has one of the best defense in this game.
Still can't get over the choice of the costumes for the Narutos.
It's so confusing. I'm losing track of who's who. You know, it's...
I'm just wondering why.
Alright, guard break pill. Good for the Sasuke combo.
Nice.
Chakra dash cancel to extend the combo and more damage.
He could have team switched to extend it.
No, because there's the thing, you would when you deal damage to the opponent, his subs fill back. So if he had extended his combo, Mirai's subs would have came back, and then since Negato had no subs, he would have been vulnerable.
Couldn't he have pressured him to like sub again and then he would have had like back to zero?
It's risky though. Here was safe by getting away.
I think it's still possible, but I guess. Let's see.
Nice. So use the staggering animation of the combo to place a special attack, the fireball. It's actually a special kind of fireball. It's mixed with the Amaterasu, which is fire that burns everything. So it goes through every single jutsu in this game. It's probably one of the most powerful jutsu, obviously. It's designed to be this way.
Yeah. Remember when it did start in the anime? It was almost one of the most epic things we had seen ever.
Alright, so Mirai is going for a full damage combo right now. It was a great tank switch. Okay, Negato's guard is red. Now maybe it needs to be so careful. If he gains enough time to get his subs back, nothing is set.
Yeah.
I think Sasuke's fireball is probably gonna... Yeah. He has two subs right now.
Ooh.
So what happens is that when your guard is staggered, you can sub. Why would you do this? Basically, it avoids you to be guard broken. Because when you're in a guard break state, you cannot sub.
Ooh. It's unfortunate. Naruto has this thing where if he tries to dash back in the air, because of his clone, it stops him or something.
Okay, so Mirai is trying to... Oh my god.
Ooh.
Negato takes it. Yeah, that wasn't...
Mirai wasn't necessarily all like... Like, you couldn't just say, oh, he's definitely going to lose. If he had...
No,
he
was no, that was really close. That was really close.
Back, he could have just pulled it off.
Of course, that was really close. And he was trying to use Naruto's hitboxes...
Yes.
...to prevent Negato from dashing him.
Yeah.
Sadly, that failed. He whiffed, yeah. And Sasuke was able to get in and finish him off.
Fair enough.
All right, it's a really interesting fight, though.
That was interesting. I mean, it was slower paced than the other matches we've seen.
Yeah, both players are very defensive.
Yeah,
so they try to gauge one another, and they wait for one another a lot. Negato is probably the most patient player I know. So if you expect him to dash at you when he's winning, when he has the health advantage, he won't. It's not going to happen.
I'm not going to lie to you, I do prefer the up-close people who go all out and then try and, like, on-site, try and... you know, defend themselves, but hey, they still produced quite an okay match. Okay, so he's locked on Tobi with the last Sasuke and Madara. And we got Obito again.
But once again, remember, the more we advance through this tournament, the higher the stakes are.
Yep.
So you cannot really blame him for being so defensive.
Exactly. I mean...
guess it's less of a spectacle. I would agree with you on that, but that's not any less interesting in my opinion, because you can learn how to defend yourselves, right? It's when you're out of subs, because many people complain that when they're out of subs, they can do anything. Well, that's not true. And you can see with Negato's playstyle that when you're out of subs, you have many tools you can use to trick your opponents.
Well, I still feel like at a visual perspective, I think everybody loves the up-close and personal stuff. But of course,
they take a lot of time before getting started, but once it started, that was pretty intense in my opinion. Anyway, let's focus on this round.
Let's see.
Alright, so okay. Both have the same amount of subs, but Mirai is about to get a third one back that he just wasted. Alright, guard break. Jutsu only. Alright. But with the bounce back effect.
Oh, nice. Maybe he knew about it. Nice. Good thing Mater is quick. Oh, nice.
So Mirai is not switching to his other characters. You could try to go with the last Sasuke, who's a really powerful character.
Yeah, the last Sasuke would give him, I feel, a really good advantage. It might be his backup.
Well,
we'll see.
Remember, Obito's combos are extremely fast and a lot of range.
I don't think he matches anywhere near last Sasuke. Personally, I hate Obito anyway.
The last Sasuke is not anywhere as good as you think he is. It's just good thanks to his combo resets. But his combo starters, they're not anywhere as good as Obito's.
I think Sasuke is much better, but I mean, hey, I guess someone who is Obito could be the last Sasuke.
No, but it doesn't change the fact that Obito's melee, his starters, is much faster and has much more range than Sasuke's.
Sasuke's got the ability to mix up his jutsu in the first place, and I mean, maybe startup combo has an effect.
Okay, so awakening time.
Okay. So I don't know about this Awakening being youthful, but it's good. Actually, no, I do know. The range is incredible.
But he has the full Susanoo, the perfect Susanoo.
As well. That's good.
Manner. Counter, perfect timing.
Obito, you know, we were talking earlier about Giant Awakenings. Obito is one of the rare smaller Awakenings who's actually almost just on par with the Giant ones.
Yeah, he does a lot of range.
Yeah.
It's really powerful too. That being said, the new Madara, the Seed Madara, has a great Awakening too.
Yeah.
Alright, so Negato is in a lot of danger when he lost.
Ooh, interesting. Wow. Interesting.
He could not adapt to that new team. But yeah, he's playing the last Sasuke now, so he's able to put a lot of pressure on the guard. Notice that between each round, the guard pressure does not reset. So he's already in the red. He has to be careful.
He has to be really careful. They're really good at putting pressure on each other. You see this?
Like, they're trying to play off with their special abilities with the ranged attacks.
So you're good. Mirai even led with a kunai to give him the edge.
Rank air break.
Ooh,
so he wasn't able to confirm it into a full combo, but. Okay. So Negato hasn't lost a lot of health right now. So if he wins this, he's all good to start the next round. So must a guard break for Mirai, yes, and there you go.
Oh, can he utilize it? Oh, no!
Wow!
To finish it.
He was fast enough. See, that's what I was saying. Obito's combos are much faster. Sasuke wouldn't have been able to finish him off like this.
I disagree with that.
Oh, that's kind of a fact.
That's just because I hate Obito.
Yeah.
But you won't win with me, even if you factually...
But you can think Sasuke's a better character. That doesn't change the fact that his combos are not as fast.
You might have still been able to get that particular win, though.
I doubt it. I main Sasuke, so I would know.
You do?
Yeah.
This Sasuke?
Yeah. He's a really strong character, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying he's any worse than Obito. I'm just saying his melee is not as fast. Sasuke cannot have finished him up with that guard break. Oh, maybe with a jutsu or something, but not with a combo.
Okay. Oh, he had Sasuke taking some damage on that too. Which doesn't matter in this game.
Right, so Mirai is using the great range of Madara to his advantage. But
Obi,
Negato is doing the same now. He got tired of getting beam-ashed.
I wonder if he can turn this around. I believe he could.
Yes, of course. He has two subs and Mirai has none. He can awaken again and it's going to be really dangerous for Mirai. Okay, now it's going to be really close because it's going to force Mirai to sub. Okay, that did not work because he got his subs back.
He just got a nice range.
And you cannot dash during that combo of Obito when the shurikens come out. You cannot dash at it.
Nice.
So it's a bit like Nagato's.
I never noticed that, actually.
Oh my god.
Wow! Wow, he turned that around, like, really nicely.
And
all he had to do was sub and continue the combo. That was ranged really nice. Yeah, that was really beautiful.
So I think it's been two matches, right?
Yes. I believe, yep, Negato won the first one. And he's won this one as well, with Obito taking the win. Obito surprised me. I might hate him a little bit less. Nah, I still hate him.
Yeah. he's a horrible character anyway.
But his star combo, definitely.
I think he's really good.
Yo, what's up?